The district still has to pay him out for the rest of the school year and until January of 2023. That's when his extended contract was supposed to expire. Was supposed to lead the district until 2023. Back in May, his contract was extended, but he didn't need to sign a new contract. Instead, he signed an amendment which states agreements made from his 2018 contract would be carried over. The 2018 contract states Dr. Jaro will get an annual salary of $320,000. It says if he is terminated by convenience by the board, Dr. Jaro shall be paid all salary and monetary equivalent of employee benefits owing to Dr. Jaro hereunder until the end of the term or extension of this agreement. It's close to $1 million, which includes a base salary, a wellness and car allowance, and other benefits until 2023. Trustee Katie Williams did not support ousting Jaro and says if Dr. Jaro sues, it will cost the school district a lot of money.
We're going to lose hundreds of thousands of dollars, if not millions, on this one decision. And all that money could have spent on our kids and now it's not.
And when experts speculate at the situation, they say that's a real possibility.
There may be claims, extra contractual claims, such as defamation or discrimination, that may be brought by a party to a contract.
As to who will lead the district for now, Trustee Williams says there is no set plan in place, but it could be discussed in the November 18th board meeting. According to Dr. Jaro's contract, he still has 30 days to carry on the superintendent's title, and he will be paid out in one check. I have reached out to Board President Linda Cavazos, trustees Danielle Ford, Lisa Guzman, and Irene Cepeda as to why they felt Dr. Jaro needed to be out, but they have remained tight-lipped all day.